in terms of computer science engineer, is data structure play a very versatile role for placement, for and for M-Tech. Suppose if you are interested in placement in product base, or you are interested in service based, then DS is mandatory for both. Okay, DS is mandatory for both, but product based, that is star marks. Okay, if you don't know here DS, then it is okay, you can place here. But product based companies, they want to be hire those candidates, they having the depth knowledge of data structure. So before starting data structure, that means before starting data structure, your C concept should be clear. Your C concept should be clear. In C concept, what we have to clear, like array, then function, then pointer, and at last structure. These points are clear before starting the data structure. That means before starting, DS. Before starting, you totally command on array, function, pointer, and structure. Okay. So in your syllabus, what we have to do, going to do, basically what we have to follow here in our syllabus, we discuss here array programming. Then we can discuss here linked list. Then here we can discuss stack. Then we can discuss here queue. Then we can discuss here binary tree. Then we can discuss here binary search tree. Binary search tree. Then we are going to discuss your graph. Then, if possible, then we can discuss heap and hashing. Okay, so these things we are going to discuss in the data structure. Okay, so now see what be the step to learn data structure. Step to learn data structure. So first stage one, C program. That means logic should be clear. Logic clear. Okay. Then stage two. In stage two, all syntax of, okay, all syntax of or of C program or basics clear hona chahiye. Then stage third, then we can start DS. This is the process, because here in data structure we are again going to use array, jo already here we can discuss array, here we can discuss here pointer also. So here again we are going to use pointer, here we can discuss again, here already structure. Then here we can be again going to use a structure. Okay, so these things are there, and here we can also discuss about function. So here also we are going to discuss about function. Okay, so these are things we should clear before starting the data structure. So what type of programs we are going to discuss? Basically, program here, we can discuss program related to array, linked list, stack, queue, binary tree, binary search tree, graph, and if time allowed, then we can discuss about here merge sort, sorting algorithm also. In sorting algorithm, what we are going to discuss, in sorting algorithm, so in sorting algorithm, in sorting algorithm, we are going to discuss about bubble sort, then second one, peak sort, then third one, merge sort, then fourth one, linear search. These are all the things we are going to discuss about in sorting problem. So these problems are very important because in a future we are going to use in. So now see why you are studying data structure. Why you study data structure? Why important data structure? Among 47, 48 paper of computer science, but we are more focused on data structure for the placement. They're not talking about the others paper. Why? So what is the logic behind this one? So as a beginner, you should know. Then we can think that this paper we are going to take us seriously or not. Otherwise, okay. Suppose you are thinking about there is no need of placement after 4 years. So that is okay. No problem. Then just focus on your classwork. Just complete your classwork and try to score high in CGPA. That is okay. If you are thinking about your purpose is only taking the degree, then that time is okay, no problem. Okay. If your purpose is the placement, then we have to do a hard work. Okay. Now see, if your data structure is strong, then automatically in higher semester we are going to discuss about algorithm is strong. If your algorithm is strong, that means your AI is strong, automatically ML is strong. Okay, so nowadays we are more focused on AI and ML. So understand this link. This link with this one, this link with this one, and this link with this one. Okay, so if your one paper is not too much enough to program, you are not able to understand algorithm, you are not able to understand AI, you are not able to understand ML. Okay, so these things, because here we can do program plus develop logic. That's why. Here we also try to develop analysis problem. We also develop here analysis problem using data structure. Okay, so these things are important for you. So basically we have to perform, suppose we have to write a linked list. In linked list program, we have to perform insertion. Okay, insertion. Then we have to perform deletion. Then we have to perform search operation. So these all the things we are going to do in ML and AI. Okay, insertion, deletion, then reverse, then count the elements, then count the element. Then find out the middle elements. So these things are there to discuss in data structure. So that's why data structure is important for you. If you one paper is weak, then automatically your data algorithm, ML and AI will be weak. So if you're thinking about we have to make a career in AI and ML, so your data structure should be strong. Otherwise, you're going to face the problem. Is it clear? So, okay. Cool. So, how many people having confidence in C programming? At least you should tell to me, yes, sir, I can do the program if program is given to me. I'm not taking told you that 100% confidence. Okay, suppose you are capable to do 90%, 60%. Yes, deep. Okay, so now see, so basically, in data structure, go for the basics. If your basic is strong, then go for the advanced programming. Advanced programming here, that means competitive programming. Competitive programming. For the competitive programming, you can follow HackerEarth. Then you can follow HackerRank. Or if you're interested to follow CodeChef, then you can follow. That means here we can analyze, this is a platform. Where can you analyze your concept, is whatever you're learning is right or wrong. That means learning is another process. These are two processes. Here we can learn. And then here we can application part. Suppose out of 100% people are interested to learn, but only 2 to 5% people can apply the application part. That's why the application part is very difficult. If you know the theory, then how can apply, that is important. So only 2 to 5% people are the successful. Okay, so that is the reason. So if your learning is good, then go for the practice for application part. So for the practice purpose, so this all the practice purpose, this is the important. That means HackerEarth, HackerRank and CodeChef, you can register yourself among all these things that can follow. But my advice is follow only one book, one site or one web. Then you can get a success. Otherwise, you can follow too many books, too many sites, and too many web. Then very difficult to improve your concept and find out the solution. Okay, of your any problem. So we can make a habit. Suppose if you are doing a code on, suppose I can do a code on HackerEarth and HackerRank. Okay, suppose I am interested to do a code on HackerEarth and HackerRank. So suppose I can follow HackerEarth. Suppose. HackerRank, then do code, and after doing code, note down to your notebook, note down to your notebook for placement or future purpose, because at the time of placement, we are not going to back to the HackerEarth and see the codes. You open your copy. You can open your copy and see your concept. Then you are able to crack that placement. So that is the process. Because we have to memorize the pattern of code. Because every code having a different pattern. So if you done this pattern before setting the placement, then you are able to do that. Then you are able to do this code. Otherwise, you are facing very problem during doing the code. If new pattern automatically comes to you, okay. Suppose you can done 400 program, definitely we are able to crack minimum 8.2 lakhs packages per annum. Okay, if you can done 400 program in 4 years. then definitely we are able to crack this one. Okay, so average package for India in good package is 6.0. okay, so in terms of IITs or NITs I'm talking about. Now see the scenario, don't go through the online videos and YouTube videos. Okay, so I can study in IIT Dhanbad, so I can tell you the reality. I'm here from the pass out from the IIT Dhanbad, so I can tell you average package of all IIT is 6.0, maybe 6.0 to 8.0, it can be vary average package. In NIT it can vary 3.5 to 4.5, like all private colleges in NIT. In triple IITs it can vary from 6.0 to 7.0, like this one is the real truth. Okay, so if you are in IIT then definitely you can get this package. If you are NIT then definitely you can get this package, and this triple IIT then you can definitely get this package. Okay, so these are the scenario. Okay, suppose you can get a package of 16 lakhs per annum through suppose Google, suppose Facebook, yeah, Flipkart, or we can say that the Goldman Sachs, yeah, Bloomberg. So this six lakhs package for 2 years, 2 years package, not per year package. So your package will be a start 8 lakhs and it will be increases to the 16 lakhs. So for first year, this one, if your performance is good, then you becomes 12 lakhs plus some intensive, you can add this one, then you can reach the 16 lakhs. You cannot get a deal directly from the 16 lakhs. Okay, suppose some companies gives 15 lakhs. So it will be a package of 3 years. That means first year some package, second year some package, then third year some package. Suppose your first year performance is not good, you cannot get here. If your second year is not enough to reach third year, they cannot get here. So that is the brackets. Okay, regarding the placement or package. Okay, so that is the real scenario of this world. Okay, don't go through the videos and think about someone is hiring for the 18 crore like this one. Okay, some people are few, those people are going to hire like a Facebook and others thing, those already do a internship that company. If you're not done internship that company, they will no one interested to hire with the 1 crore package or 80 lakhs package. If you can done internship from that company, then they will interested to hire you because already see your work. How can you do that? Okay, is it clear? So anyone interested to ask any question? Yeah, your doubt is clear. Okay, so basically in your syllabus 15 programs are there. In program we can follow what is the structure we can follow in the lab. So in the lab I can discuss only logics and syntax and the coding part done by yourself. That means you can done, and after doing the code each and every day you will start making your lab manual. That means write down the code on the Word file and take a screenshot of compiler and paste it and convert it. Because at the last end of this semester, I'm not going to tell you that you can make a lab record and then submit me. But from starting of the lab, from starting of the day, we can start preparing. Whatever I can discuss in the class, that codes are enough. Okay. Suppose I can discuss 10 codes in a classroom, then you can make a 10 lab sheet manual of the 10 programs and then can submit it. Okay, at the end of the semester I only put the deadline to submit your lab manual. So that time no one can ask me, sir, you cannot told me that, you cannot make me, I am not able to do that, you are already late, too many pressures on that, other things will be happen. Yeah, Ankur, tell me.
सर मतलब हमें जो लेब मैनुअल है वो डिजिटल बनानी है या हैंड रिटन?
नो डिजिटल आप बनाओ, हैंड रिटन क्यों बनाओ, इतना मेहनत नहीं करना है. ओके
ओके सर.
ठीक है।
यस सर।
आप क्या करना, कोड लिखना डिजिटल में, दैट मीन्स वर्ड फाइल में, और आपने जो उस कोड को कंपाइल करोगे उसका आउटपुट अटैच कर देना, तो आपका एक फाइल हो गया। सपोज आई कैन डिस्कस कॉल बाई वैल्यू एंड कॉल बाई रेफरेंस प्रोग्राम, सो राइट द कॉल बाई वैल्यू एंड कॉल बाई रेफरेंस प्रोग्राम, अटैच द कंपाइल फाइल एंड दैट इज एनफ। ओके, सो दिस वे वी कैन प्रोसीड थ्रू आउट द सेमेस्टर। ओके, एंड बी प्रेजेंट इन योर लैब, अदरवाइज व्हाट हैपेंड, इफ आई कैन पुट द अब्सेंट देन योर not reaching the 75%, then they may be face problem. Okay, suppose if you are absent, then you can inform me. Okay, so this way we can follow throughout the semester, and I hope you can learn and enjoy with me during the learning period of data structure. First point is that be focused, decide what you have to do. If you want to become a programmer, then that means we can start doing hard work from today. Okay, that means you can day, at least you can do a program, one program in a day. Okay, you have to do a one program in a day for increasing your knowledge, for increasing your analysis power. Okay, the analysis is very important. So can you tell me how can define a structure, what is the difference between a structure and union, because you already completed C programming? Anyone, what is the difference between a structure and a union?
Sir, can I try?
A structure and union mein difference kya hai, Ankur?
Sir, structure mein jo hota hai, hum log means jab different types of data types usme define karenge, to un sab ki jo space hoti hai ek ek ki, wo total karega aur utni space wo memory mein le lega. यूनियन में क्या होगा कि जो अलग अलग डेटा टाइप हमने उसके अंदर रखी है, उसमें से सबसे सबसे बड़ी जो डेटा टाइप होगी उसकी मेमोरी वो देखेगा और उतनी मेमोरी सिर्फ यूज करेगा।
ओके, करेक्ट। यही डिफरेंस है कि डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, सॉरी स्ट्रक्चर यूनियन में। और कोई डिफरेंस है अंकुर?
याद तो नहीं है।
ओके, सो एक ये डिफरेंस है। दूसरा डिफरेंस है क्या है कि इफ यू वांट टू एक्सेस डिफरेंट डिफरेंट डेटा साइट्स, डेटा टाइप इन स्ट्रक्चर, दैट इज पॉसिबल, बट इन यूनियन वी कैन एक्सेस ओनली वन डेटा टाइप एट अ सेम टाइम। ओके, बिकॉज वेयर मेमोरी इज नॉट शेयरेबल ना, ओनली वन मेमोरी लोकेशन, एंड हियर मेमोरी इज शेयरेबल अमॉन्ग ऑल द डेटा टाइप, then we can access multiple data type in a structure, but in union we can access only one data type. Clear?
Yes sir.
तो ये दो डिफरेंस है जो बेसिकली आपसे पूछे जाते हैं। और स्ट्रक्चर मेंबर्स को कैसे एक्सेस करते हैं, एनीवन नो हाउ टू एक्सेस स्ट्रक्चर मेंबर इन स्ट्रक्चर?
डॉट ऑपरेटर सर।
हाँ,
डॉट ऑपरेटर सर।
यस यस, या डॉट ऑपरेटर। Okay, thank you. And only one person, no? Rest? Neil? Javik? Jay? Vishal? No one, no? So our first program we are going to discuss in the next lab, that means the Friday lab. We start from here. Call by value or call by reference, both program we are going to use pointer. Okay, so call by value and call by reference, anyone know what is the difference between call by value and call by reference, because that is the C programming?
Sir, कॉल बाय वैल्यू में हमें वैल्यू मींस फंक्शन को प्रोवाइड करने पड़ेगी, और रेफरेंस में हम एड्रेस प्रोवाइड करेंगे।
यस यस, करेक्ट करेक्ट। सो हियर वी कैन ओनली पास कॉल बाय वैल्यू, दैट मींस पास द वैल्यू डायरेक्टली टू फंक्शन। वी कैन पास द वैल्यू डायरेक्टली टू द फंक्शन, बट हियर इन पास द address of वैल्यू टू द फंक्शन, दैट मीन्स जो वैल्यू हमारी एड्रेस की होगी वही उसकी एड्रेस को हम लोग पास करते हैं. तो यहां सपोज हमने पास करेंगे 2,4 और यहां हम लोग पास करेंगे, सपोज हमने 2,4 किसका पास किया, ए का और बी का, बट इन रेफरेंस में वी कैन पास एड्रेस ऑफ ए कॉमा एड्रेस ऑफ बी. ओके, वी कैन पास द एड्रेस ऑफ ए एंड एड्रेस ऑफ बी इन कॉल बाय रेफरेंस. इज इट क्लियर? सो फॉर द एड्रेस पर्पस वी आर यूजिंग द पॉइंटर. So address representation, we can use the pointer, and we can call, sometimes we call the formal parameters, and actual parameter concept we are going to study when we pass. Then what is the effect on the actual parameter and what is the effect on the formal parameter will be happened in call by reference, sorry, call by value and call by reference. So whatever I'm writing, that is a readable format, na? You are understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is okay. You need more zoom?
No, sir. It is visible, clear.
Okay. So these things we are going to discuss in the first lab: call by value and call by reference using pointer. Then we can move forward. So before one thing, you can go for matrix multiplication also before starting matrix multiplication and addition. Okay, so you can cover this one like a 2D array, because we are using array here in linked list, in a stack, in a queue also. Okay, we are going to use array in linked list, stack and queue. Okay, so these things, though, so that's why array is important. So we have a log yes follow karenge in sabko array ke programs ko sare ke through karenge. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, agar aap book ki baat kare to you can follow this book. Already share with your batchmate. This book you can follow. I can show you this one book. For everyone can follow, even if IITs and NITs, all student of India follow this book. Wait, and show the book. So this book we can follow. That means for the lifelong data structuring algorithm made easy, this one. Okay, so this book is a standard we can follow. So if you want to follow this book, then go for it. Otherwise, if you want interested to follow any other book, then you can follow. Okay. So for the beginners, this book is very important. And this is written by the IIT Bombay student, MTech student. Everything you find out, logical, technical questions, interview questions, competitive programming, everything related to your subject. Okay, so this book is important for you. And if you want to follow this one, follow. Otherwise, for the data structure algorithm, other books are there. So we can follow also books there. This books also. Okay. Clear? Okay, so this book, I think I can share this book already. This book is shared with I think I can tell you. This book is shared with TC2. And this book also share with No, not a TC1. Okay, TC1 I can share this book. Okay.